sitting quietly for an hour without moving will reduce one day in your lifespan. The same time you stand and just move your legs, your lifespan one day is added. Simple thing is, if you want to be happy, give somebody happiness. Sitting quietly for an hour without moving will reduce one day in your lifespan. The same time you stand and just move your legs, your lifespan one day is added. Now the topic is something new, because I think Vijay had told me that it will be, what is it? Wellness concept. Stress management, okay, stress management. Now time management is also there. Management, because management must come, no? All the manage, because the management department. Right, Preeti? Manage, you know management? Comes from manas. This part of the body is called manas. So people used to control the horse. That's why the management comes from there. Of course, today management means money. That's a different thing. Well, managing anything is easy, whether it's time, whether it's health, whatever you have, other than economics. All the other things are very easy. My friend from China is an economist because, you know, they do all kinds of research. Well, let's now think of wellness vis-a-vis illness. We don't want to be ill, do you? You want to be well, right? Very simple, very simple. What's the difference between the two? Okay, let me ask you a simpler question. How can you be happy? Happiness index. How many of you have read this wonderful book called In Search of Happiness? Any hands up? Viktor Frankl is a psychiatry professor in the United States of America, but he was in the concentration camp. Hitler had put him in the concentration camp. He was a Jew, a very bright psychiatrist in Germany. And he had the visa to go to the United States and a job also in the United States, but he preferred not to go because his father, his mother, and his pregnant wife were also in the concentration camp. So he said, I shall not go to the United States of America. I'll live here with these people and see whether we'll all be relieved. So to cut the long story short, first his wife, pregnant wife died. So two deaths, mother died, father died, and one by one the concentration camp people started dying, but he did not die. He did not die. And then, you know, eventually he says they lived on urine and others' meat, dead people's meat, and somehow he got released, Hitler died, and then he lands in the United States of America, becomes a professor of psychiatry, and writes this beautiful book. Please read that. Simple thing is, if you want to be happy, give somebody happiness. Christine, an American poet, has so beautifully said, if love is what you give away, love is what comes back each day. It's like a mirror. You know, you give somebody happiness, you get happiness back. Good, 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 good. Sit down here. No, these chairs are vacant. Sit down. Sit down. Good girls. 3 by 2. No, there are 3 chairs. Okay. Ella ungum pinnale ukkandirukanga. So you, if you want to be happy, you must give somebody happiness. How do you manage time? Does time move? Time doesn't move. The same time, my grandmother's time also is the same time. Events move. Quantum physics calls it happenings. Events move. You know, we were in the other department a little while ago, and we sent some time there. Now we are in this department right ago. Do you know what is stress and what is distress? Everything in life is a stress. And without stress, you will die, wither away and die within 1 week. There's the African ritual called the voodoo. That is, if a thief or a murderer or a rapist is found there is no Supreme Court there. There used to be no Supreme Court in the Aboriginal race. This, he was taken to the chief. And there will be an advocate who will say, this man did this, 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 this. If the chief feels it is right, he will take a bone, dead man's bone, and show it at the person like that. That is called Udo, V-O-O-D-O-O. And we had done some work on the hearts of these people. Very interesting. After the Udo, the man is not supposed to be talked to by anybody in the society, in that village. But he will get good food, and has got a nice outhouse outside the village, where even his wife and children are supposed to go and talk to him. Nobody talks to him, right? But he is fed very well. Actually, probably much more nutritious food than what he would have had in life in the house. None of these people live more than, last more than 1 week. They're dead. The belief, the superstitious belief was that showing the bone is the bad signal, and he died. But the fact is, these people's heart becomes very vulnerable for fibrillation. So we replicated that in pigs. What you used to do is, you put a pig in a cage and is very hungry, give it nice appetizing food, and the pig comes running. And then as it comes running near the thing, it gets a sharp electric current there, very painful. So it goes back. Again hungry, comes in. Second time, third time, nth time, the pig gets so frustrated. Pig says, I don't want food. It goes back to the cage, lies down. It is frustrated and depressed. At this stage, we can fibrillate and kill the pig with 1 joule current, 1 joule current. A normal pig requires 100 joules current. And 1 joule current you generate by even lifting your hand like that, you generate 1 joule current. So these people die because of fibrillating heart. And these hearts, when you look at them, they're absolutely normal. It's called electric death. See how the things are? Where is this all from? What is stress? Stress is a part of life. Getting married, is as stressful as getting divorced. I'm not joking. It's absolutely right. But divorce is distress. Marriage is eustress. The difference is, stress you can bend in a different way. If you bend under stress, it becomes, young lady, distress. Good, this girl is writing. Very good girl. But if you enjoy that, marriage, you think, oh, that was, of course, the definition was given by Samuel Johnson, second marriage. Triumph of hope over experience. So marriage is eustress, but divorce is distress. So now the Western youth neither want eustress nor want distress, so they cohabit and never get married. Because for them, for economic reasons, marriage is very expensive, divorce is more expensive. So why have that? After all, you want to cohabit, just live in relationships. And the government has now given legal sanction for the children born out of that also. That's nothing problem. And the inheritance, etc., there are some laws. I'm not very sure. Our professor of economics will tell you about that later. Now, what I'm saying is, don't you ever think that if I want a stress-free life, I should never have any stress. You will never grow. You must have stress. That's why, if you don't work, if you say, I don't just want rest, I'm just not doing anything. If you don't do anything, you will be surprised. Within 124 hours, a lot of changes occur in your body which are detrimental to your health. Now, Vijay was asking me, are you tired? And I was seeing patients from morning, 8:30. And then we came and some other department and something. But changing this, time management is very simple. Don't do the same thing for a long time. You get distressed. Supposing she had asked me to see 2 more patients, I would have run away. But she said, talk to the students. Oh, it's nice fun, I've been doing that for donkey's years. You probably don't know. I started teaching in 1962. And I've been teaching ever since. And teach every day, even today, all over the world. I've taught thousands of students. But I enjoy that.